expect me to stay, like I'm your only escape.
What's good, y'all? It's your sis Erica Vane back again with another Sistas video. And in this video, we're breaking down the preview to episode 10. Child, let's get into it. All right, y'all, things are getting good. I'm so excited. Okay, so the preview picks up right where the episode ends with Zach, and come to find out he ain't lose all his money, y'all. Zach gotta be one of the luckiest Negroes you have seen. Name a luckier Negro. I'll wait. What? Yo, his $20,000 or his $19,900 investment in that stock did not tank. It must have flipped and turned around. You know how that happens. Like, we hear those stories all the time. And now he has $787,000. Zach is almost a millionaire overnight out of nowhere. And listen, if you haven't already, check out my episode 9 breakdown video, because we were talking about him and Fatima. They actually made a little bit of strides, even though they had a very, very tough conversation. And the fact that he got all this money now, I'm like, okay. Not that the money needs to change anything, but it does change some things. And again, Zach revealed some things while he was talking to Fatima, so make sure you check out that video, because I talked a lot more about their relationship in that video and what's next for them. But Zach got money, like money, and I wonder how he is going to be. Like, that's crazy. And when you think about it, like, they could go a lot of different ways. Like, Tyler Perry is Tyler Perry, y'all. This could go either way. It's basically like he hit the lottery. I wonder if Zach is about to buy a house, if he about to set himself up really nice. Is he about to really jump into this relationship with Fatima? Child, we only going into 10 episodes into this season of Sistas. We're not even, I think maybe next week we might be the mid-season finale. I'm not 100% sure. But I'll double check on that and give you guys an update in my predictions video. So be sure to hit the subscribe button so that you do not miss when I post another Sistas video. But I'm excited. That one part alone in the preview got me excited. Like, Zach got some money that he can really set himself up with. He has not had his own place this whole time, his own car this whole time. And now he's going to be able to do so much for himself and really be able to ground himself. A lot of his problems have come from like money troubles, and a lot of his worries has come from that. So this is also, in my opinion, going to force him to not necessarily lean on the money excuse. And then now let's see who you're going to be. You know, you hear that money, not that I think that's going to make him a bad person or anything like that, but just to have this conversation, you hear that people say like money isn't the root of all evil. Money makes you more of who you are. So we're about to see exactly who Zach is, and I'm excited about it. But y'all, that's if he's gonna be able to keep the money, because when he goes into the bank to talk about the stocks and what happened in this big windfall of cash, the banker asks him, how did he know that the stock would do this? And of course he lies. Hoochah. This is going to get interesting. One thing I am excited about, that this bank has more workers than Sabrina and more recent Jacoby, because it's given y'all never have no customers. There's always a bunch of drama. How do y'all even stay in business? You know, but he meets with another banker at the Brookhaven Bank. So hopefully we're about to see that expand a little bit. Then child, in the preview, we go into Maurice and his little tenderoni of the night. I can't even remember dude's name. I just keep calling him Scammer Guy. I gotta do better, since clearly he's about to stick around for a little bit. But him and Scammer Guy are sitting there. We already know that they had an amazing time. Maurice really enjoyed the sex. Okay, girl. And because Scammer Guy don't have no job, don't have nothing to do, he like, yo, what we doing today? Maurice is like, I gotta go to work. This is interesting, because Scammer Guy did not, when they were about to have sex, Scammer Guy was like, oh yeah, I don't be doing all this romance and touching this, I'm only a top, I'm only this and all of that. And now you talk about some what we doing today, he's giving very much so boyfriend vibes. He's giving let's make this a thing, even though the night before he was giving, you know, it's strictly sex. So it's going to be interesting to see where this goes, or how they actually use this character. I'm still a little bit confused by him and why we're trusting the scammer. But you know, if you like it, I love it. And if it keeps Maurice out of Sabrina's hair, then by all means go ahead and let it happen, because he's out here ruining Sabrina's life left and right. So And finally, we get a little bit more, or it looks like we're going to get a little bit more in episode 10 by way of Danny's explanation of what's going on with Preston. This girl has been ducking, dodging, and rolling under the car, hiding from this man, and now we get a little bit of understanding about why. She's on the phone with Sabrina in the preview, and she says she finally has a good guy, but it still feels like something's missing. Okay, sis, we can work with that. What do you feel like is missing? What do you feel like you don't like? Like, can we just continue the lines of communication, articulate what we need so that we can move forward? Because this, you sleeping on the couch, you being evasive, you hiding from him, all of it is given very much so self-sabotage, very much so I don't think I'm deserving, very much so you need to do better because, girl, you deserve all of this and more. And your good sis E, as well as your other sisters, is sick of it, okay? And then we end the preview with the co-counsel that was popped up on by Gary when he was meeting with Andi and Chow. Again, make sure that y'all watch my episode 9 breakdown because I talked about this in depth, honey. This was a very good beat, I felt like, in the series and to show what Andi and Gary's relationship is given to people who don't even know them. But, you know, I ain't gonna go back over it in this video. But we end with him coming to the office and them, I guess, getting to a settlement finally with the clients that their respective clients. And he's like, you might be seeing me around. I definitely think that he is moving to Atlanta, child. He might be coming to this firm. And he about to give Gary a run for his money, and I'm here for it. I am here for it. I would love for Andi to be able to move on and be great without a man and just take some time to herself. But if she needs another man to be able to swap into place and swap Gary out, then by golly, Miss Molly, let's do it. Because Gary has got to go. I've been saying this. I'm not going to stop saying it. There's nothing that Gary's going to be able to do to make me believe that she needs to stay with him. And that's that. All right, y'all. That is my quick preview of episode 10 of season 3 of Sistas. Be sure to hit the like button because you made it all the way to the end of the video and I know that you liked it, as well as subscribe to the channel. I'm dropping new Sistas videos every day. And let me know what you thought. Let me know what you thought about episode 9. Let me know what you expect for episode 10 in the comment section down below. I will be responding to every single comment that I get. I'm looking forward to chatting with you more about Sistas. This is a series that we love, y'all, and I love talking about it with you. If you missed any of my Sistas coverage, I got my Sistas playlist linked for you right here, as well as 2 suggestions for other series that you might really love, really vibe with, really want to get into. So check it out, grab a snack, watch another video, and I'm gonna see you tomorrow in my next new one. Bye.